Hi, so you want to equip your stationary PC with a solid-state drive and need a simple step-by-step tutorial? You're in the right place. Let's get started. First thing to do is to unplug the power cord. And hold the power button for about 2 seconds to discharge all the capacitors. Next, we need to find a way to remove these two panels. In most cases, there are 2 or 3 screws for each panel that you need to remove. And we're inside. That's my old hard drive. The case was designed for 3.5-inch drives, and most SSDs are in the 2.5-inch format. We need a 2.5 to 3.5-inch adapter. Some SSDs are shipped with the adapter like this one, so if you're buying it for a stationary PC, it will be handy. If you don't have the adapter, you can buy one for about $5. Let's mount the adapter and install the SSD in the computer. These 4 screws will hold the SSD in place. Align the drive so we can see the holes and fasten all 4 screws. Now let's connect one of the SATA power connectors and a SATA cable. Be sure to connect the SATA cable to the first port on your motherboard. It's usually labeled as SATA 0. If your old hard drive was connected to this port, you can unplug it and hook it up to the next free SATA socket. We chose the SSD to be the system drive, and we don't want to have Windows on the SSD, which is loaded from the hard drive, right? As far as I remember, during installation, Windows should write the bootloader to the disk connected to the first channel, in our case SATA 0, meaning the SSD. By the way, my motherboard is pretty old, and it has only SATA 2 ports, which can handle up to 300 megabytes per second, so I decided to buy a PCI Express SATA 3 controller. Theoretically, it supports 600 megabytes per second bandwidth throughput, but in practice, it turned out to be up to 50% slower than my motherboard's SATA 2 controller. Don't buy this particular controller, you will waste about $12. It's absolutely useless. Let's go back to the tutorial. All the cables are connected, so it's time to check if your computer can detect the new solid-state drive. Close the panels, but don't fasten the screws yet. Connect the power cable, monitor and keyboard. And turn on the computer. If you can find your new SSD and the old hard drive on the list, it means both drives were detected and everything works just fine. You can turn off the computer and fasten the case screws. You have just upgraded your PC and you're ready to install your operating system. If you like this tutorial or find it useful, please share it so more people can watch it. Consider subscribing so you won't miss my new videos. Thanks for watching and see you next time.